I was on a call today, and Bailey was talking about, it was in the Beachbody Champions page. So if you're not in that page, it's a page run by Beachbody, and I'll add you to the group. I think you have to be invited. And Jamie was talking about everybody who's like inactive. So obviously it's, if a coach is inactive under you, like how to reach out to them. And she said something that she wrote a message to each one of her people, and I'm going to share it in the chat. And I just thought it was like so real and raw, and also like kind of what we all need right now. Like if somebody, oh, is it not going to let me paste? Okay. I'll read it to you. Hey, beautiful, long time no talk. I hope you and your family are safe, staying safe during this pandemic. I know that even with my anxiety, I'm trying to stay focused on what I can control, and that's me. I've been trying to stay consistent with getting good sleep, doing my workouts, drinking Shakeology, eating well, and getting some sort of exercise every day during this lockdown. I'm starting a new program, blah, blah, blah. I noticed your account was inactive, so I just wanted to see where I could help. Do you want me to join me and get back on track with your health with the help of this new program? Or would you like to cancel your coach account so that no further payments come out of your account? I want to help you decide what is best, and I want to help you stay focused by prioritizing your health. If you're interested in canceling, I can help you find the form. And if you're interested in joining my test group with the new program, I'd be happy to let you in on the packages available for you. I would love to see where your head's at and see how I can help in any way. I'm always here for you. And like, obviously we don't want to lose coaches, right? Like we work really hard to get them, but I thought that was a really good message even for like a potential customer. Like, oh, that's weird. Oh, I wonder if someone, oh, I think Carmen logged in under me. Sorry, Carmen, you freaked me out. Okay. It's fine. I gave her my login so she could start her morning workouts. Okay. So basically I wanted to share that with you because, and I shared that with Carmen earlier because she has a bunch of inactive coaches under her. But I think it's like a really important thing to check in with people and be real. And even if they are just a customer, like just, you know, like, I don't mean that, but check in with them and say, hey, how are you doing during this time? What can I do to help you? You know, what's going on that I can, like, how can I help support you during this time? And I think that like something so simple like that would go a long way. Okay. I'm going to share my screen because I have a, what'd you say it? Presentation. Okay. Here we go again. I can never figure this out. And I do this every week. Share. Okay. Here we go. All right. View, present. Wow. I did it. That's amazing. Okay. Let's scroll up to the top. Okay. So today, March 23rd, woohoo. So you guys, this is the last week of the month to get paid. So just keep that in mind. And then I was actually looking at April, and there's actually 5 weeks that we can get paid in April, which is kind of cool. But this is the last week of this month to get paid. So, I have two brand new coaches that are hopefully going to hop on at some point during this call. Three. Amber has joined us in January with Bar, but this time it's really hard for her to get on. And she lives in Los Gatos, which is in the Bay Area in San Francisco. And then Haley G, she is a brand new coach that she actually is sick with the flu right now. So let's send her some love because she's a little scared. And then another Haley who lives in town, and she owns a small gym and is looking to start helping people virtually. So if those people hop on and you're wondering who they are, I'm going to ask them to introduce themselves if they pop on. So far, Addie's at SC2, Christine SC2, Noletta SC2, and I'm at SC15. I'm still pushing for SC20. That's kind of like my sweet spot, where I feel like I can help those people and, like 10 people a month. So I'm still pushing, and I'm still going for it. Just because we only have a couple days left doesn't mean I'm not going to get there. And you guys can totally get to SC6 too. It's absolutely like a mindset thing. And especially during this time, it's offering to help people and how you can get them going with at-home workouts and a nutrition plan during this time when they're home. I just also want to let you know that I want to shout out Noletta, who is pushing for Diamond right now, which is really, really exciting. That's like a huge step in her business. And I just wanted to say I'm really proud of her for taking the time and dedication for doing the business activities to get her to that point. So she has 7 coaches under her, Christine being one of them. And so she just needs 3 more, and then for Christine to have 2 coaches under her, and then she's Diamond. So pretty exciting and really proud of you, Noletta. So we have our free group going on until Thursday, and it's been amazing. The feedback has been awesome so far. I know some of you have, actually a lot of you have people in there. Thank you, everybody, particularly Christine, who's been checking in on that every single day because it shows the community and camaraderie. So I really appreciate you doing that. And that's been great. So basically, we offered a free group for the last week to see if people were interested in this lifestyle, or maybe just to help them out while they were quarantined at home. And like maybe they're going to go back to Orange Theory in 2 weeks, but at least we could help them out right now. The most challenging part about running a free group is the conversation that comes at the end of the group where you say, okay, would you like to upgrade to a challenge pack? And they say, well, I've already been on the website and I see the $99, so I'm just going to do that. So it's having that conversation about like the total nutrition and fitness plan. A lot of coaches actually don't allow people into their groups, like the Healthy Habits community, unless they buy a challenge pack. So that's kind of like on a personal level. I'll let anybody you guys want in. But just so you know, like a lot of people will say the benefits of joining me with a challenge pack is you get the one-on-one. You get the nutrition call. You get the weekly meal plans, because the ones that I send out, you guys can all send out. So when you do have those conversations with people that are interested, share that with them, that it's actually more than just the workouts and this is what you get. And I was talking to Melissa today, who is on in my downline. She's under Carmen and she's been wanting to work the business. And she said, oh, she just has 2 fellow nurses right now who are just doing the 14-day free trial. And I said, well, have you spoken to them about doing a challenge pack when they want to, you know, sign up? And she's like, well, no. And I gave her tough love and I said, girlfriend, we are adding value to these people's lives. Like, this is a total nutrition plan and bring the value. If you're working with these nurses every single day, bring them a beach bar. Tell them about your shakes. Tell them how it makes you feel. So don't be afraid to talk about the product with the people that may be pushing back a little bit because they're concerned about that they don't think that they need our product. Okay. Another reminder that summit tickets are only $170 through the end of the month. And, let's see, 10 rounds is now available for coaches. So if anyone's planning on doing that, I think Addie, you might be wanting to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, great. So it's a brand new program, and I'm trying to get this to stay over here. Every time Beachbody launches a brand new program, you have to pay for it because it's brand new. And it's like early access. So this 10 rounds is not even going to be available in the Beachbody on demand library until like maybe July or August. So that's why they promote it this way, to get people excited about it. And that's what I want to talk about today too, is like how you get people excited about a new group. And then the Zoom workout link. So that's available to everybody and anybody. I'm struggling with it a little bit because I'm Pacific time and I don't get out of bed normally till 6:30. And so I'm really not launching it till like 6:40, 6:45. And Carmen's also been launching it. So if anybody is up like earlier in the morning and wants to launch it, I'd be happy to send you my link. Also, I'm going to upgrade to the unlimited plan because right now we get cut off after 40 minutes and then have to relaunch, and that's pretty annoying for the workout group. It'd be better just to like have someone start it when they wake up and then have it run until like 9 a.m. Pacific or something. But interestingly enough, like in our quarantine group, I asked when people were working out, and most people are working out in the evenings. And I thought that was like super interesting, and I was not expecting that. Okay, so with everything happening right now, I wanted to talk a little bit about Dana. I feel like I know him, but I don't know him. It's like creepy, you know.
You gotta meet him eventually.
Okay, so I want to talk about like what to do right now in our business. So following up with clients, this business is getting people results and having them feel confident. So let's take two examples. Okay. Somebody signs up just with the Beachbody on Demand, does the workouts kind of half-ass, shows up a little bit, checks in a couple times a week. Okay, that's fine, but they're not going to get the results because they're not focused on nutrition, the total body, the whole thing, right? Or does somebody signed up with a challenge pack? They've invested that money in themselves. It's obviously not cheap, right? And they're doing the shakes every day. Maybe they're doing pre-workout every day. They're doing the workouts. They're checking in every single day for 21 days. And like, that's how they get started. Think about that and how their results are, right? Like in their energy and excitement behind it because they've committed. So we're in the business of getting people results. So if somebody's not showing up in your challenge group and you've invited them as a customer, check in with them. I've texted everybody who 3 weeks ago were checking in every day and now they're gone. I'm like, hey, where are you? Just checking in, like making sure you're okay. Some people just get busy and obviously this is a crazy time, but you have to check in with those people constantly in order to make sure that they're getting the results. And some people need more of a push than others. Are you inviting to coaching? You know, and audit your Insta. That means your stories and your feed. Like, do you have a coaching post up that's recent? You know, do you have a fitness post up that's recent? Do you have an entertainment post up that's recent of something that's entertaining? So we're striving to post once a day. I know that's hard when you're not used to it, but audit your Insta and see where you need help and ask me. I'm here for all of you. Like, happy to help you with all of this. Okay, and then really quick, I'm going to jump off the, and show you Linktree and collecting emails. So today in that call, I was inspired by Jamie, and she was talking, let me just show you. Before, my internet is so slow today, and people are saying that because everybody's online. Okay, so it's called Linktree. It's free and you can just create your own. And basically I have joined my team, at home workouts, my Amazon store, my blog, shop, my outfits. Okay. So as of like 2 hours ago, I had like 7, 8 links. And I feel like it was confusing. So when you click this link, it takes you to a Google form. And the reason why I like utilizing Google Forms is because if Instagram is gone tomorrow, which it could be because we don't know, we don't own the company, we can't control that, what do you have? Like, do you have email addresses? Like, do you have them stocked up, right? So I'm going to log in the back end and show you about the Google Forms. And you're going to kind of get freaked out because I have so many. And that's why I decided to, like, cancel all of these and just do one. Instead, but like this one for a 3-week bootcamp, okay, has 44 responses. This is from like since January 1st or whatever. Okay, so like all these people, and I asked them questions like, what's your first and last name? What's your email? What are you looking to change in the next 3 weeks? What's your biggest struggle nutrition wise? How are you interested in joining? You know, whatever. And then, but the thing is, I'm collecting their email addresses, and so, it's really awesome because then I have an entire list of emails of all these people that if Instagram is gone tomorrow, I can email all of them and still help them. So I would highly recommend getting on Google Forms. It's totally free. And then when you create your form, you can just press this little button, send, and then you can take this little link, copy the link, and then go to Linktree. I'll go on the back end here. You can log in. And then you can see it's really easy. You can just edit the links here and just put the new link in there. So that's been super helpful for me. And like, I had all these other links that I had at periods of time. And I realized it's actually much easier, I think, for somebody brand new trying to figure this out if there's limited options. It's like you go to the Cheesecake Factory and you have no idea what to have because there's a 500 options, but you go to pizza and you're either going to get like one of two things, right? Pizza or pizza. So just another thing. And then another thing too is like, I decided to beef up my virtual health coach info here and ask a couple more questions. So why do you want to be a coach? Where do you live? What's your Instagram handle so I can creep on them? And then are you looking to coach part-time or full-time? And any other comments? And this question is great because then you can like know if people are going to be, if they want to run with it or they just want to do it like when they have time. Because if someone says, oh, I just want to do it part-time and like maybe pay for like some vacation, then you know how much you as a coach want to put time into them. Because if they say, I want to do this full-time like in the next 2 months, then you're like, okay, girl, here we go. You know, like watch this training, let's do this, let's auto your Insta, let's do all these things. So you can kind of, it helps to be able to have people run with it or not. It helps you figure out how to coach. Okay. The other thing is remember your why. So write it down on your tracker. So every day on the, every week on my tracker, I write down my why. And my why is to take the financial burden off Austin and to bring him home from work. So that's my why. And that's really what it is. And my target market is pre-baby people, people with a baby or post-baby. And I want to connect with those people because that's the stage of life that I'm in. And you know, Christine's potentially buying a house. So like maybe you should look for hashtag like new homeowners or just bought or whatever, like whatever hashtags make sense for that. And I want to talk about that too. Actually, we can talk about that now. So when you're doing a hashtag and you're doing hashtags, like you can save them in your notes for like Monday hashtags or whatever. If it's like a specific thing or Friday hashtag, weekend hashtags that make sense for the weekend. But I think it's really important to tailor your hashtags toward what you're talking about. So if you posted a smoothie recipe, I would hashtag things like vegan smoothie recipe, whey protein smoothie recipe, green smoothie recipe, easy smoothie recipe, healthy meal prep. And then I would also post things about you, type 1 diabetic, horse mom, you know, animal, whatever, like, and try to find ones that don't have a million people on them because then it's going to be harder to be seen. But so when you're doing hashtags, post about the product, like pre-workout drink, and then also like Amazon shaker bottle, right? Like that's so stupid, but like that's somebody also looking at that. And like, that could be somebody who might be interested in talking to you. So think about you. And oftentimes I ask people to have a friend tell them what they think they're all about, right? So like if you're like the type of breed of your dog, your favorite workout gear, right? Like I always try to tag like my workout gear, like hashtag Amazon fitness finds, hashtag whatever, like you get the point. But there should be a combo both of like what you're talking about immediately and also like Queensland healer mom, even though my dog wasn't in my picture. But if somebody is searching that hashtag and sees my picture that's like me working out, they might be like, well, that's weird. Why is that on there? Click it and then be like, oh, that's cool. Maybe I should join her. The other thing is too, Noletta and I were talking the other day about signing up with a significant other. And the reason why I'm talking about this briefly is because, like for me, Austin is under me on one of my legs. And when the time comes that I want to build him to diamond, I can do that. But right now I keep him active and I have people under him. And so he gets commission. So when he gets commission under me, it basically doubles and then I get commission under him. So it's a great opportunity to earn more money for this doing no work. So I just wanted to like remind you guys that, and that's something that you can do like right away or in the future when you're interested in like really growing. And I know, like, for Noletta, so, like, she, this is a perfect example. So she has Christine, obviously, on her right, or on your left, I can't remember. And then she has Zach on her other leg, right? And so she's going to make Zach emerald, and then Christine's going to go emerald, so she has a diamond. And if she didn't have Zach, she would have to find another person who was willing to put in the work, just like Christine is showing up and willing to put in the work. And that sometimes takes longer than you want. So that's just a great kind of, like, I know that Nalette and I were talking about that the other day. And also Carmen and I today had a one-on-one for an hour, a working session talking about getting her diamond back. And she has Rusty on one of her legs, and then another friend that she can make active. And then under that person, she has her mom. So it's like, you know, I don't have any of my family members besides Austin. Like, my family's not supportive that way. But if they were, you'd bet your ass I'd have them everywhere so I could be buying stuff under them, having them help me out. Okay. And then Shakeology, you guys, I got a pushback today on Shakeology that somebody's going to buy a different protein powder at Trader Joe's because it's much less expensive. But I would just encourage you to say that if you get pushback like I did, I just said, I totally get it. But it is $4 a day and it is, you know, technically a meal replacement. You do add other stuff to it, but, you know, so talk about the benefits of that. And then I suggested to her to sign up with the discount so she can save almost $20 every month if she did order. It's a hard conversation, and some people are going to want to do it and some aren't, and some are going to see the value and some aren't. So, like, for me, that's probably a loss, but it is what it is. And then, you guys, let's encourage all of our new people that are joining us to take before photos. And this is a great way to build, like, your library of affirmations. And I've talked about this before. So in my phone, I have a photo album under my photos, and it's called Affirmations. And I have 50 things in here right now. And it's just texts people have sent me across the course of, you know, me working with them so that I can use them. Because on our tracker, it says recognize people every day. Well, sometimes I don't always have something to say. But I do have this, and I do have before and after pictures from people who have joined me, you know, and that's really valuable, and it's always nice to pull from that. So I'm constantly asking people, how's it going, when I check in with them, and then screenshotting and adding it to this thing. So the thing about that is that's why I often ask, like, let's all share our before and afters, because then we can use those to our advantage and help create community that way. So encouraging people to take before pictures, and also to measure, because that girl that I shouted out today in our group, Claire, she'd never measured before. And if she hadn't measured, she was like, I had to measure 3 times because I could not believe the inches. It's like, yeah, dude, measuring is awesome because it's so much different than the weight on the scale, because weight can be water and blah, blah, blah. And then scheduling nutrition calls with clients. So you guys know that I've been doing this a lot. And if you don't know what to do or how to set up that call, I recorded a YouTube video and added it to our team page. But that just adds value. So if somebody's signing up with you, immediately as a customer or a coach, just say, okay, great. When can I schedule a nutrition call with you so we can go over your nutrition plan so I can help you reach your goals? Like, boom, like the next day, like that afternoon, 2 days from now, like get it on the calendar, show them that you want to help them get the results. And that means that they will take a much bigger interest in this because they feel like you're invested in them on a personal level. Let's see. But that's been like huge because I've had a lot of people who I did, because I just started doing that. I've had a lot of people buy stuff in the last week because of that. Okay, so April planning, I know because it's the last week of March. I was thinking, you guys, we could do a book club. That would be kind of fun. And Carl Deichler, our CEO, on the call this morning was talking about The Obstacle is a Way by Ryan Holiday. So the timeless art of turning trials into triumph. And so I was thinking we could read that as a group if anybody was interested. And then I was going to open up to healthy habits too. And then we could, like, have like a weekly like check-in about the book in Healthy Habits, and that might be like another conversation starter and might be a great way to get some of our customers interested in personal development, which is one of our vital behaviors as coaches. So I'm going to order that. I encourage you all to do the same. You can also, I think, do it on Audible too. And then on April 13th, I know it's like far out, but I'm just putting the bug in your ear. If anybody would like to lead this call, we have a doctor's appointment to see baby in 3D. And so I don't think I'll be able to make it, but I don't want to cancel our call. So if anyone wants to lead like an action hour where you guys like literally just get on and work, let me know. I think that could be great.
That would be fun. I don't know where I'll be on April 13th, but I would be down to do it. Real quick, though, I wanted to touch base on something, if you don't mind.
Please. I'm done.
You mentioned talking about – I'm sorry, these peacocks. Oh, my God. So you mentioned when people go to Trader Joe's and they buy protein powder. Well, this is something that I deal with on a daily basis with supplements for horses. And have to keep in mind is quality matters. And the thing with Beachbody and Shakeology is they have been around for 20 something years, and they've taken the time to research and put the quality into it that needs to be there, and all those ingredients are in there for a reason. And so the fact that you can compare protein powders if you want for people, but when it comes down to it, a lot of them don't compare to the amount of superfoods that are in there. And I would just tell them, like, oh my gosh, and it doesn't have to be true, but just tell them, I've totally had the same, you know, mindset as you. I get it. Sometimes it can feel expensive. I've tried other protein powders and, you know, they just didn't quite work for me because they weren't as filling, or, you know, you can make these things up as you go, or if you've experienced it, then even better. But like, you know, honestly, I don't think I've ever found a beach, like a Shakeology comparison, because Shakeology always makes me feel full. And like even being pregnant, like that's been a huge thing, is to feel full and satisfied. And so just keep little things like that in mind. Quality matters, and Beachbody puts in the work to have the quality there. So
I love that. Thank you. Yeah. It's so true. But it's hard when people are like, well, like this girl, she was like, well, I found a similar protein with a lot of the superfoods. I'm like, no, you didn't. Like, you know, it might be a lot of them, but it's not all of them. And like, who's sourcing those? Are they from sustainable resources?
Exactly. That's what you should say, you know, but it's hard not to offend them at first and be like, I would have just said something similar because that's what I talk to clients all day about. But you know, I thought the same thing.
Yeah.
You know, I thought the same thing. And when I started putting pen to paper and comparing them or trying them out or, looking at where they source their ingredients from, that's an eye-opener for people, because sometimes they'll try and call companies and companies won't get back to them about where they source their ingredients from. And that's a scary thought right now.
Yikes.
Because, like, there's a lot of different areas you can source ingredients from. So.
Yeah, that's super scary. Well, thank you for saying that, because that's one of the hardest things in our business that people deal with. Like, one of the hardest. So thanks. No. Okay, so you guys, Carmen asked me to talk about this. She's off the call now, but she was like, what if you only have 15 minutes? What do you do? What if you only have 30 minutes? What do you do? Okay, you guys. Invite. Grow your Instagram connection base. Like, that is all you should be doing if you only have a small pocket of time. If you're worried about not having stories, pre-record them. Like, or take a picture as you go and upload it later. Like, you don't need to feel the sense of urgency when we're all busy and working to add things right that second. But just, like, take a snapshot. Like, Nola has been so great at that. Yesterday I spent like an hour and a half on my phone. Austin was like, your eyes are going to pop out of your head. And I was like, yeah, I know, homie, but like, I'm trying to like make our dreams come true. And literally, like, I just connected people. Like, I was hashtagging San Antonio bloggers Queensland Healer, Bernie, Texas, Texas Hill Country, Cowboy's Wife, Tracking Macros, like all these random ones. And I was like looking through trying to find people that I actually could potentially relate to, you know, and like have something in common with, like, oh my God, like I like dream of living in Texas or whatever, you know, like making a connection. And that's how I've been getting my cold market to warm market. So I woke up this morning with a bunch of new views on my stories, which is huge for me because recently it's been the same people over and over and over. And that's so frustrating. One of the calls this morning was talking about attracting people versus being desperate. So if you're ever feeling like, hey, I'm just checking up with you one more time, like, and you're like feeling desperate about it, and like, have you checked out the link? Like, I keep doing that, and I find myself doing that because it's our natural instinct once we spent time with people to want to get them to check out, and I get that, but they sense the desperation, you know, and I think that it can be really obvious, and if you've ever felt that from somebody, you know that too. So instead, work on like the attraction role where you're providing the value and you're wanting to, you know, you're attracting them through what you're offering. And I really think that absolutely comes down to mindset. And this is the deal. People don't join because of Beachbody. They join because of you, your story. They see themselves in you. So ask people why they picked you. There are so many coaches out there, but your story is why they chose you. Like, they're relating to you because of you.
Yeah, can I give tips real quick? Well, that's what we call it, Mark. That sounds so stupid.
But
they call it chips. And Christine, oh, yeah. I can see her face.
Yeah, but, platinum. It's hilarious.
Yeah. But to touch base on that, if anybody hasn't checked out Christine's Instagram lately, I feel like she's done a really good job of stepping up to the plate, posting the workouts every day, like showing the before and after pictures. And shit, I want to look like that.
Me too. Oh my God, girlfriend, can you grow and hurry up and get out so we can get back?
No.
No kidding. But
you're so sweet.
No, but it's true. I mean, people see that and they really want what you have. So yeah, keep that in mind. Because I was on a couple of those Zoom calls that Lauren's talking about, and one of her coaches, Nicole, well, her main coach, was talking about the people she follows and attracting people that she wants as her coaches. And so, like, going to people's pages like Lauren's that attract her. And then when she's inviting, she's kind of looking at these people as, like, are you similar to me? Are you going to want to do what I'm doing? And so just, yeah, right. Keep that in mind because it helps. Because I never thought of that. Like, she gave an example, like, if you went to this gal's page and she's like this gothic gal
right.
who has none of the same interests, she's probably not going to follow you back.
So. But
it's probably not going to happen.
Yeah, and I've done that a lot where I'm like, I'm just liking these photos of these people, like, down the list on their feed, but like, I don't even connect with them. So I'm like, why am I wasting my time with that? Like, that's why yesterday I got like narrow on who I was, like, instead of just going through, like, actually finding people that you think, like, you don't know, but you think you could connect with. So smart. Great tips.
Makes sense.
Questions? I'm done with everything. Sorry, that was a lot, but any questions or comments or anyone struggling with anything?
Nope.
Okay.
I'd say the only thing I'm struggling with, which watching the wake up call this morning kind of helped, was like how to invite right now without feeling like you're pressuring people or trying to sell them on anything, because it's like not the time to do that, you know?
Yeah.
And I think I kind of got my message down, but it took a little while, a little bit of configurating.
What are you saying?
Just basically, like, hope you're doing okay. It's a crazy time. Wanted to introduce myself and let you know I'm in a 21-day at-home fit program. It's been great to get women together and create some camaraderie and focus on building each other up.
We'd love to have you, but I'm also happy to help you in any way, shape, or form during this chaotic time, blah, blah, blah.
Perfect.
That kind of thing.
I mean, see, that's a thing, like, if any of you receive that message in your inbox, that's not offensive at all. Like, that's how you
know
about it, you know?
Yeah, I was just trying to think of, like what, oh my God, what was the gal on the call's name this morning?
I forget. I listened to it, too.
Yeah, I can't remember. But she was saying, like, how would you want to be spoken to, basically? So I just try to think about that.
I love that, because it's so much more than just like copying and pasting. That's what I was telling Carmen. I said, I've done so much less copy paste the last 2 weeks and my numbers are growing. And it's because I'm like, instead of just like feeding it to people, I'm like actually responding in real time, having a conversation, asking questions, and like having this engaging back and forth instead of being like, here's all of this script and then like, let me know, you know? So it's a good lesson that I think we have all gone through. But yeah, I think you're doing great with that.
I love that. I think.
Go ahead now. Everyone.
Oh, I can't believe how delayed that was. Oh, it's okay. Are we frozen? Am I frozen?
No, you're good now.
No. Okay. I was just gonna say I was kind of struggling with the fact of, I think we talked about it, but. Well, right now is everyone's offering like free workouts for people, you know, and so I think our quarantine group has helped, but then I guess what we have to keep in mind is that I guess these are going to just fade off, like the free groups, and then people are going to have to buy something. So it was basically for me trying to get people to buy during this time of free everything.
For everything and like a surplus of free workouts online, and I get that, but it's also like I said, like we're just going to provide more. So when the group's over on Thursday, like we're going to start talking about how they can join and sign up for something bigger and longer than just that time. And I really think that people are not going to go back to their gyms for weeks and weeks and weeks. So. And a lot of people pay $100 a month for their gym, and this is $160 one-time fee. So, by the way, if we get cut off, let's take a quick pick. Okay, guys, okay. Ready?
No, I like that.
Okay. Yeah, you know that we're going to provide value, so we'll start talking about that.
With a knife in my hand.
Whatever, just knife with your baby. It's not dangerous at all. But yeah, we'll start talking about that and transition people.
Okay. Yeah, that would be super helpful for me.
Tips. Yeah, that's a good idea. I know it's going to be not a challenge, but it's going to be an interesting thing to get people to transition. And I'm interested to see, some people might say no, and then they realize they can't go back to their gyms, and then they might come back, you know?
Yeah, I think that'll be good.
Yeah. Okay, well, let me know if you have questions this week, you guys. I'm here for you. If anyone wants a one-on-one, let me know.
Thank you.
Okay,
thank you.
Bye.